up everybody. The bottom line, I'm a black intellect, but I'm refined. We precision like a bullet, target bound.
All right, so I'm gonna go over one of the lures that's been doing the best for me this spring, and most places I fish, whether it's a shallow pond or a deeper lake. And I'm going to kind of share why I think that it's working so well, and why I think it's one of the best lures to have in your tackle box, if not the best series of lures to have in your tackle box.
It's always good to have an assortment of lures that resemble popular bait fish in your area. So this happens to be my assortment of yellow perch lures.
So before picking any lure that you're going to use for like most of the day on an excursion, whether it's in a kayak or on the shore, you're going to want to know the location and understand the geography and the environment of not only the lake itself or the pond itself, and you know what lies beneath it, but you're going to want to just pay attention to what's around you. You know, look for downed trees, or if there's a lot of trees in one spot, patches of weeds and lily pads, even, you know, steep slopes along the side of the bodies of water. You'll find a lot of time those slopes continue down into the lake or pond itself, and that's actually going to hold a lot of bass. Bass like to sit along ledges, and they look for, you know, rocky or tree structure a lot of the time, or even weeds.
So I think yellow perch are one of the most popular bait fish around here. So I just have a bunch of different sized, shaped, swimming depth yellow perch pattern lures here. This one, the bill actually broke off of, but you can see it'll swim different because it's jointed. This one's got a really long bill and it's rather heavy, or this one's got a little bit of a shorter bill, a little smaller, still tied on there. This is a little bit more of like a small jerk bait. Does work on small bass and pickerel and big sunfish. And this thing is doing work on bass as well. These top two have been putting the hurting on the bass so far this year. And I think it's just because they swim like, you know, typical bait fish would, typical perch would, and they look really realistic in the water, and their presentation is well done. So it's good to keep lures like this in your tackle box if you plan on fishing in areas where there are yellow perch and there are species that will go after them.
So basically what I look for in this video at this particular body of water is shallow pockets of weeds. Where, you know, I can run my lure just above the actual tops of the weeds, but a few feet still below the surface of the water. It seems to be working out pretty well. So I look for, you know, little inlets and coves, but I also fish, you know, points that kind of jut out further into the water than most parts of the shoreline do. So a lot of the times there are steeper drop-offs there, and I'll, you know, fish along those or fish along tall grasses and weeds that I notice alongside the shoreline as well.
So I had to reorder some lures, and I actually tried to order the same lure that I lost here last time because it does so well, and I got the wrong size, but it's bigger. So we're going to hopefully get some bigger fish with that exact lure, just in a bigger size. Same color. It's actually the Rapala Rip and Wrap. I know that's a mouthful, but it's a great lure, and it makes for a great sound and attraction in the water this time of year. It's in perch color, if you're wondering. So let's get out there and try to get some fat bass today. This is the lure I've been using all day today. Oh, it's a relatively deep diver, 5 to 8 feet, I think. It's the Rapala Shad Wrap in yellow perch. It's gotten me two bass, four massive bluegill, and a really annoying pickerel. I'm in a tree right now, and he's a little guy, so I'm not even gonna weigh him. I'm just gonna throw him back, revive him a little bit. He's all right. All right, let me get out of this tree.
All right, 1 pound, 11 ounces. Gonna get this fish back because it's cold. There we go. Look at that thing. Hand is covered. Look at the size of it. Absolutely massive bluegill. Let's let him go. Dude, biggest bluegill I've ever caught for sure. Crazy big bluegill number two. Look at that thing. Absolutely massive. And another one. You could have been dinner, bro. You and your friends. Y'all are huge. They love to splash when they go too. Bass are more chill. All right, Mr. Fat Sunfish. Here you go. He's, oh, there he's still in the net. No, don't swim down.
That's two bass today. Four big sunfish.
And one stupidly big pickerel. She jumped into my boat. Dude, I've never seen that. Fish jumped, tried to jump into my boat. Wild.
Oh shit, I have a fish on. Oh my god. Hey buddy. All right. It's a bigger one. Damn, he took it. He really took it. Right through the upper lip. I was like, why am I snagged right now? Decent sized fish. I knew there was one over there. You gonna chill out now? Can't reach his mouth. Come here. Fish number five or six, either way. Doesn't matter. Not as big as I'm looking for. That's the problem. Jeez, there we go. Alright. Another decent sized fish.
it's a sunfish, goddammit. I hate you. At least I got a video of one of these. So you can see how friggin' ridiculous they are. Treble hook. That feels like pickerel. Oh, it is. I knew it. I hate you. I hate you. Shake off. He's barely hooked. Oh my god, he almost jumped into the boat. I'm gonna try to lip grip him here. These fish, this is huge, dude. Don't you break my rod. I just gotta pick him up once. Look at this slime, this slimy beast. All right, I'm putting him back. Woo!
Massive bluegill. Six today.
Little dinkies. Little dinkaroo. Put them back. Oh, damn it.
Dude, if you splash me again, you're gonna make me lose my mind on you. Annoying. Dude, I am drenched from these guys today. Three pickerel today. Add that to the board. That's the 20th fish. All right, I'm gonna throw him back because he's a feisty.
But there you go. Nice teeth on them. Yeah, get away. They drenched my entire boat. Hit like a bass. Gonna weigh him real quick.